This week began with a relaxing mushroom picking trip to Cauxie, where we were not nearly as successful as our local friends, but like Pepsi loved us all the same. I have enough footage from this trip for it to have its own video, so look for that on my channel soon if you would like to see it. I met my second class of students. We debated animal rights and the importance of the environment, all while learning new technologies, vocabulary, and laughing at ourselves. I made my first school visit to meet 3rd, 11th, and 12th grade teachers to discuss how my presence could benefit their classrooms, and enjoyed viewing the student art and spirited decorations all over the walls.
I think this is Estonian artist.
It was a fairly rainy week, but I think I'm adapting to the weather pretty well. It helps that Vita Team is always visited by enthusiastic people from all over the world for workshops, conferences, and projects. I participated in Code for Youth, a conference geared towards youth workers and teachers hoping to expand their skills in youth empowerment. The week was dense with methods, experience sharing, reflection, good food at a Dali-themed restaurant, and energizers. We played a communication game where I learned that context is always relevant and that I can be really easily distracted sometimes. Along with the conference, I helped students prepare for Vita Team's annual harvest party, where the community celebrates the end of one season and the opening of a new one, with intercultural food and activities. At Code, we used figurines to depict ourselves and how we felt each day, which seemed really silly at first, but was actually a very helpful practice. My figure is the Yoda.
Try to find what is similar in them and what is
the... Honestly, the learning never stopped. From the difference between informal and non-formal learning, Shia LaBeouf's ability to motivate anyone at any time.
So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Just do it!
To the taste of a fish found only in the Narva River, this week was all about growth. We had a night of sharing our cultures where I realized that my dancing is in desperate need of improvement. A visiting 10-year-old taught us judo, the participants got to know each other, and we all piled on a bus to go to a Narva Yesu spa. I didn't take any video inside because we weren't really wearing clothes, but it was amazing. I'm not sure if the spa experience would be considered authentically Estonian since it wasn't in the middle of the woods in a cabin with a pond, but eating at the campfire bar and watching new friends from Greece and Croatia try to fix the broken glasses of another friend from Romania was a small thing that made the trip so memorable.
Ma olen kunagi üritanud sinna. See ongi see saar, eks?
Before everyone left, we made sure to take a night tour of Narva, telling each other stories and practicing languages. And the next morning was the harvest party. I made Southwest potato salad from Pinterest and loved seeing Vita Team's house so full of people.
Okay,
I'm so grateful to have met all of these new friends, and I hope that I get to see them again soon.
Hi, my name is Jill, and if you are at this part of the video, it means you watched the whole thing, so thank you for that. You just saw week 3 of my time here in Estonia. I am here until June. So if you would like to follow me on this journey, then you can find videos here. Subscribe if you want. Also, I have a lot of footage left over from mushroom picking, and I will be posting that video in a couple of days. So if you want to see that, you should subscribe. Have a good week.